Yes, look, we've got a fresh angle now of what actually transpired in those frantic seconds that there was that assassination attempt on Donald Trump. We have pictures of a reverse angle here that shows Donald Trump actually speaking at the podium, and then we see one of those Secret Service detail guards on a rooftop firing back towards that gunfire. Have a look.
And you know, that's a little bit old, that chart's a couple of months old, and if you want to really see something that's said, take a look at what happened.
Wow. Now, we're also just learning that the Associated Press is reporting that an AR-style rifle has now also been found at this scene. We understand it was found outside, again, the perimeter of this event today. But those pictures there, quite shocking. It shows the seconds in which the Secret Service detail who were there, and there was a huge detail. They follow a former president around. And they are stationed on those rooftops around. They have responded in seconds, guys. They're quite a remarkable angle to what has transpired.
You know, David, that's extraordinary because that's happening, reacting in milliseconds there. We'll keep a look at this vision, but just as we're talking, we're being told right now that he has definitely left the hospital as well, David.
Yes, we've just heard that in the past couple of seconds. In fact, his motorcade has been seen leaving. We assume that the former President Donald Trump is with that motorcade right now. You're looking at these pictures. They have lights and sirens going. It is the way that Donald Trump travels. He gets that privilege. He gets to ride like that in that motorcade with the Secret Service. So nothing too unusual there. But he is leaving just hours after being taken into that hospital to be checked by those medical professionals. So we've already heard from the former president. He said he's fine, but perhaps an example of that right there. He is now leaving hospital.
And David, you were saying earlier that he actually had a planned event this evening. Do we think he's going to go ahead with that? Would he do that?
We're just trying to firm that up at the moment. There had been a suggestion that he had been scheduled to actually attend a UFC rally in Denver, Texas. Now, I don't know if you've seen pictures of Donald Trump actually attending these rallies before, but if there was a Venn diagram between US fans and MAGA fans, there is a huge overlap in the middle. And often when he walks into these stadiums, he gets a hero's welcome. So he had been scheduled to attend one of those. We are just trying to firm up if indeed he is now still going to attend that event. But if he did, that would be remarkable given what has happened today.
David, I just want to talk to what we're looking at the screen. I know you can see it as well. I'm amazed by this. This is an extraordinary moment because the snipers are reacting within milliseconds here. So look to the... Trump's down the bottom right. There's the sniper on the roof. Trump ducks. The sniper begins to fire. From this, we can deduce that the snipers have stopped that attacker shooting Trump further. The reaction is that quickly, that fast.
As you point out, it is within milliseconds. You can see that person. Well, first of all, you see Donald Trump react. He's up there. He throws his hands around his head. Something appears to be bothering him. And we now know that they are bullets. And then in the background, that Secret Service detail, I'm just looking at those images now, he reacts within seconds, as you say. They are trained to do this. The good news is they haven't been forced to actually draw on those skills in a very, very long time in American history, at least modern history. But here we see it in action. This is what these guys actually train for. And we see these guys at events, major events all the time. And Ange, you would know this from your time here as well. You go to any event. It could be a Joe Biden event. It could be a Donald Trump event. They take no chances with security. There are that detail. They are on rooftops, often around the event perimeter, particularly if it is an open-air event. And we've seen it there now. They respond within seconds. An incredible effort there from the Secret Service detail. But just on that, guys, and I'll just tell you one extra thing as well that we're starting to learn, is that the head of the Secret Service is now going to be called in for Congress. Of course, there's going to be a major, investigation into how this actually happened and how it was actually allowed to happen. So congressional leaders are already demanding answers.
David, let's stay in this moment, though, because we're going to bring up a still image on the screen, which we've sourced from an AP photographer. Now, what's circled in red might explain what Donald Trump said in his statement about he heard whizzing. Now, that's a bullet, as best as we can make out, that's travelling to the right of screen past Donald Trump's right-hand side. We know from what he said, his first-hand account was he heard a whizzing sound, then he felt a bullet striking him at the top of the right of his ear. Now, look, we're sourcing this from an AP photographer. We'll take that as gospel at this stage, but that would be an extraordinary image, if accurate, of one of those bullets that would appear to have missed Donald Trump or perhaps might be the one that struck him and carried on.
That is going to be photo of the century, if indeed it is a real photo at the moment. We must preface all of this by saying that the internet right now is flooded with false information, and we are trying to get those images and that information from the best sources that we can right now. But that has been attributed to a photographer at the New York Times, an incredible picture. It does appear to show that bullet. And what is quite remarkable about this is Donald Trump is now saying that that bullet has gone on to pierce his ear on the right-hand side of his face, or the right-hand part of his ear. How it has then avoided his skull is another question entirely. The logistics of that seem quite incredible at this stage, that Donald Trump has walked away from this unscathed. But that picture itself, I mean, that paints 1,000 words. The terror of that moment, that bullet, whizzing towards a man who was the former president of the United States and, of course, a man who wants to be again.